Welcome. Today,
We will see
laboratory manual, pharmaceutical engineering, BPharm, semester 3. Practicals. Myself, Namdeep Shinde, assistant professor, Department of Pharmaceutics, Satara College of Pharmacy, Begon, Satara. Under Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar, Technological University, Lonere, Raigarh.
Today, we'll start with first experiment that is based on heat transfer mechanism. Title of today's experiment is to determine radiation constant of iron. Requirements for this practical are iron cylinder, thermometer, stopwatch, pair of tongue, tripod stand, gas burner, weighing balance, metal scale, micrometer, screw gauge. Regarding theory part, heat flows from region of higher temperature to the region of lower temperature. So this heat flow takes place by conduction, convection and radiation mechanism. In diagram, in picture, you can see how this actually takes place. So here you can say at the base there is burner, so it is emitting energy to the space. That is nothing but radiation. Secondly, you can see from burner energy is transferred to the solid, then to the liquid. So that is what convection mechanism is. And you can see handle. So that is what energy is transferred from in a single body from one molecule to another. So that is what conduction mechanism is. So in short, we can say conduction is nothing but the transfer of heat that occurs when there is temperature difference present across a material. So that means simply there is conduction, transfer of energy from hotter body to the colder one. So generally it is observed in case of solids and liquids. Convection, the transfer of heat occurs in liquids by movement of molecules during mixing. So generally in case of liquids, we can say because of mixing, there is movement of molecule. And by that movement, charge, energy will be transferred from one molecule to another. That is convection. And last one is radiation. The transfer of energy by electromagnetic radiation from radiation emitting surface through space. So sunlight is an example comes under radiation. So here energy will be supplied to the space from radiation emitting surface. This is formula for determination of radiation constant. M into dT by dT is equal to H1A upon Cp in bracket T minus T air bracket complete plus H2A upon Cp in bracket T4 minus TS4 bracket complete. So in short, M is nothing but mass of radiating body. So we are using iron cylinder. We have to check weight of that particular iron cylinder. dT by dT, rate of heat loss from radiating surface. So that can be calculated by plotting graph. Temperature versus time. H1 is nothing but heat transfer coefficient by pure convection mechanism, while H2 is nothing but radiation constant for iron. A is nothing but surface area of hot body. Cp is nothing but specific heat of iron. T is nothing but temperature for iron cylinder. T air, that is nothing but temperature of air, and T is nothing but temperature of surrounding. Here for this experiment, we can use either iron cylinder or brass cylinder. So this is diagrammatic representation for how we can arrange this iron cylinder, tripod stand, burner, thermometer, etc. Actual procedure, we will see in short. Take a smooth iron surface of iron cylinder and drill to fit a thermometer into it. So that is first step. We have to add thermometer having capacity 360 degree centigrade into that cavity of iron cylinder. Then clean the iron cylinder thoroughly with cloth and weigh accurately. So weight is required for calculation purpose. We have to measure weight, measure the dimensions of iron cylinder. We have to check its height, then diameter, radius accordingly, that can be considered in calculation part. Record the temperature. We have to record room temperature so that we can go for further process. Insert the thermometer into the cavity of iron cylinder and put it on tripod stand with heating. Heat the cylinder for 300 degree centigrade temperature and transfer it on non-conducting wooden surface with pair of tongue. So we have to transfer that particular cylinder once it reaches 300 degree centigrade temperature. Temperature of cylinder is start to lower because of we are transferring the that particular set stopwatch and record change in temperature and until it reaches to room temperature unit time. And by using that data, we have to plot the graph between temperature in degree centigrade and rate of temperature change with time. Plot the graph between time in minute and temperature in degree centigrade. Slope of the line will give value for H1A upon Cp. Calculate the coefficient of convection and radiation constant for iron cylinder by using formula which we have already discussed. In this practical, before starting the actual practical procedure, we need to check weight of iron cylinder, we need to check height, diameter of iron cylinder, radius of iron cylinder, area of iron cylinder, and room temperature. So once we check all these parameters, then
welcome. Today's experiment is based on heat transfer mechanism. So for this practical requirement is we need a hollow metal cylinder. This is iron cylinder. Then we need a pair of tongue. This is wire gauze. This is tripod stand, burner, and most importantly we need a thermometer. And for placing this cylinder we need wooden surface. Regarding theoretical part, heat transfer mechanism, heat transfer takes place by three different mechanisms, that is conduction, convection and radiation. So regarding conduction, that means transfer of energy from one body to another takes place by conduction mechanism, and convection means it is observed generally in liquids, and in case of radiation we have example of sunlight. Regarding this practical, in working we have to arrange like this. This is tripod stand, wire mesh is there, and this is a hollow metal cylinder. Regarding its dimensions, we have to check height of the cylinder, then radius and diameter of the cylinder, and surface area can be measured by using formula that we will see in calculation part. Firstly, we have to check room temperature, and now it's 26 degree centigrade. Okay, now we have to start the procedure. We need to dip this thermometer in hollow metal cylinder and we have to start heating. Now we have started burner. We have started heating. We have to heat this metal cylinder, iron cylinder, up to 300 degree centigrade temperature. So we have to check conduction mechanism. Conduction, that means here at first when we start this burner, at lower point get heated firstly, then slowly it total cylinder get heated. So we have to heat it up to 300 degree centigrade. Once we heat this up to 300 degree centigrade, we have to kept it aside on metal wooden surface. Now we will wait for 300 degree centigrade. Okay, now it's heating, temperature is slowly rising. Now it's 35 degree centigrade, so we will wait up to 300 degree centigrade. Now you can see temperature is reaching 300 degree centigrade. Now we have to remove this cylinder. First we need to dismantle this thermometer probe, and we have to shift this hollow metal cylinder having 300 degree centigrade temperature. Now we have to record the temperature change for every 10 minute interval. Now I am starting this for 10 minutes, so I have to record the temperature of hollow metal cylinder after 10 minutes. So now we will wait for 10 minutes, then we will see how much temperature is there.
Once we complete experimental work, then based on observations, we have to go for calculation. This is observation table here. Time in minute is given, and once we reach 300 degree centigrade temperature heating, from that we have to transfer that cylinder to the wooden surface, and we have to check change in temperature per unit time. So at the interval of 10 minute we have to check change in temperature, and based on these values we have to calculate radiation constant for iron cylinder. This is formula we have already discussed that part, and by putting all these observations values in this formula we can get radiation constant for given iron cylinder. Thank you.